The PC that I've got here is running on Windows 11, but it's still booting up in the old legacy BIOS boot option, and that's because the drive I've got here is formatted as an MBR, and in this video I'm going to show you how to convert it to GPT for free, and then set your boot options to UEFI, so you can then boot back into Windows. So to start, you can right click on your start button, whether you're using Windows 10 or Windows 11, this will work the same. Then you can click on Disk Management. And then what you need to check here is what disk number you have in your computer. If you have multiple disks, you need to check which one is your C drive and what the disk number is. So I've only got one disk in this PC. And just to show you that it is MBR, if I right click on it and then click on Properties, then go to Volumes, you can see that the partition style here is Master Boot Record, which is MBR. So to convert it, I now have my disk number here, which is disk 0. And to convert it, you can just click on the start button and then type CMD. So you can open the command prompt as an administrator. Then you can just click on yes if you do get any prompts. Now the first command that you want to run here is the following. It's MBR to GPT space forward slash validate space forward slash disk colon and then the number of the disk that you want to convert. So I've determined that my disk is disk 0, then space forward slash allow full OS. You can then press enter and it's just going to validate the disk first and tell you if the command can run successfully, if it can be converted. Then the next command that you want to run is the same command, but you can just change the validate to convert. So it's going to be MBR to GPT space forward slash convert, and then space forward slash the disk with the number, then space forward slash allow full OS. Then you can press enter, and then it's going to start the conversion. And then once it's finished, you're going to see this message that before you can boot into your new system, you need to switch your BIOS or your firmware to boot in UEFI mode. So to do that, you can then just close the command prompt, then you can restart your computer. And this is going to be different on your computer, but I have a Gigabyte motherboard, so I'm going to press delete while the computer is starting up. And that's going to take me into the BIOS. Now, what I need to have a look at here is any setting related to CSM or UEFI. So as you can see here, I've got CSM support down here. I've got that set to always, and that means it's still going to try and boot in the old legacy BIOS way. So I'm going to select that and then just change it to never. Now, if I go ahead and save these changes, the computer will restart again, and we should be booting back into Windows from the UEFI boot option. And there we go, it's automatically loading into Windows. And now if we go back and we go to Disk Management, and we have a look at Disk 0, and we have a look at the properties, inside of the Volumes tab, this is now a GPT partition scheme. Another thing I should mention is you might see this system reserved partition show up, which you didn't have before. If that happens, you can just go back to Disk Management and then you can find the system reserved partition. Then you can just select it and right click on it. Then you can click on change drive letter and paths. And then you just want to click on remove, so you can remove that drive letter. Then click on yes. And then it's just going to remove the drive letter, but the partition will still be on the drive. And if you go back to this PC, you should only have your local disk C without any system reserved partition showing there. But I hope this guide's been useful. Please like the video and I'll talk to you guys soon.